everybody, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and today we are out on the prairie again at the Redeemer United Church of Christ
in Sussex, Wisconsin.
And we have been here in the fall and then again when we were collecting seeds, but we haven't done what the prairie looks like in the winter. Now, since we haven't had any snow since December, we haven't been able to get out here and show you what the snow looks like in the prairie. But then 2 days ago, we got dumped on by lake effect snow, and at our home, we had 7 to 9 inches of snow. Out here, they may have had just a little bit less. But even though today it's crispy, it's in the 20s, the sun is shining. Tomorrow it's going to be in the high 30s, and the next day it's going to be in the mid 40s, and then rain. So today's the day to get the picture of snow on the prairie, or it's going to be gone again. So we thought, what a perfect time. And although our very informative and knowledgeable guides, Nancy and Rick Volbrick, aren't here with us today, hopefully they're somewhere where it's nice and warm. We're going to do our best, and we're going to show you what it looks like from our perspective.
Well, I see the seed patch right behind you here.
Oh, yes. Well, all the seeds that they hadn't collected, and they do collect a lot of seeds and put them where they want them. Many of them, of course, are still out here, and the birds and the animals have been eating them all winter as a food source. So it's wonderful to see that there are still some very tall plants that are still here, and down below the surface, because these are all native plants and the frost only goes to 4 feet, those roots of the native plants can go really, really deep, far deeper than 4 feet. So there is activity going on here whether we can see it or not.
Especially below ground. I saw a deer trail.
Yes.
Let's go look at it.
Yes. We, of course, have been tromping around in the snow, as have other people. We've seen other people out here just walking around because it's so beautiful out today. But we also see that there are deer tracks here, which means at least one deer has been walking around in here, looking for things to eat or just moving to a safer place to stay.
Well, I can see them as they cross that little hollow there, going to the south of those maple trees.
Yes.
You can see their trail heading there.
Definitely, and we can hear the crows cawing in the background.
And I see our footprints.
We did lots of good ones.
Yeah. That's amazing what still exists above ground. Here we are, you know, the middle of March. And again, we had no snow in January or February.
Just very little.
And in one day, we had more snow than we had in 2 months.
Right. Yeah, which is very unusual for us. Usually we have snow from late November all the way through at least the
July.
End of March. Sometimes into April, and once we remember it in May. But, you know, that's the weather. Nobody can control it. Mother Nature has her way.
Well, that's why they invented margaritas.
At this time of year, it's easier to see the topography of the land because the plants are in their skeleton form. They have a very long swale at this side of the property, and that's so that when the water washes off, it doesn't run someplace else. It stays on the property, and the plants themselves can use it. So the plants that are in these deeper valleys here are obviously water-loving plants, and they will stay green almost all summer because of that. Something that we've noticed in the last days since the snow has fallen is we have no rabbit tracks in our yard, and that is very unusual. The last time it snowed in December, it would look like they were having ballroom dancing classes in our class. It was just covered with rabbit tracks. Nothing in the front and nothing in the back. And we're seeing that here too. There are no rabbit tracks.
Maybe they went on vacation down south with Nancy and Rick.
That could be. Now we can tell that this is a sumac It's like a tree that turns into a bush, or a bush that turns into a tree if you let it go. And those will be the seeds that are forming there, so it's very easy to see. And then over there you can see the evergreens, which that's why they call them evergreens, because they stay green all the time.
Here's an evergreen box right here too.
No.
Oh, that's no. Green.
So that's why it's nice to have a mixture of plants in your yard, because you'll have something that stays green, even though it's a different color green in the winter, and you'll also have nice greeny things during the summertime. But it's always nice to see a touch of green against the white snow.
Like Kermit the Frog?
Ribbit. In this little swale behind us, you can see that the cattails are still up. You can tell by the seed heads on them. And then beyond that, where it gets a little bit shallower, is where they had the very, very tall blue-stem grass. And then in front of that was the shorter little blue stem. And they also had some oat grass there, I think, and switchblade grass. So lots of different grasses. You can see some of them, but most of them are down now. And come spring, you know, they'll be flattened down and the new stems will come up. Finally, we have some more tracks. I think the first ones here are going to be the deer tracks. As you can see, those two toes there. And then over here, where there's the dragging, looks like something dragging, are wild turkeys. So they've been out here.
Yeah, and then there's more over here too, so. They seem to have a shorter little drag tail to it than the other path.
Maybe there was a little one. This is a little area that they've added on. It's like a sanctuary, an outside sanctuary or a remembrance garden. And there's places to sit and a whole variety of different flowers and plants in there. We think we're not going to walk in there. We're going to just leave it and not leave any of our tracks there.
Pristine.
But it's pretty just like it is. And you can hear the oak trees. The leaves are still on the trees and you can hear them.
You could become a leaf wrangler.
I already am. Over my shoulder is an area that they have not yet developed. Somewhere in the future they will, but you can see that it's pretty flat and there's not much vegetation sticking up in there. So I think mostly they just cut that at this point. This time of year it's fun because you can look at the plants and they're just starting to get ready to bud out. We've had such warm weather. We've already had 70 degree weather. And this is a viburnum that seems to be already budding.
Yeah, it's amazing. Just full of them.
Yes. You can also tell that this is a perfect time of year for trimming.
Look at that.
Yes, this has been chewed off by a deer. You can tell because it's kind of jaggedy. Yeah,
there's another ragged edge there. Mm-hmm. Another one down here.
Yep, well, they get hungry. So yep. They will. You can tell that these have been clipped and it's not by a person trimming. These have been trimmed by deer all along the outer edges. You can see
everyone. Especially with these raggy edges. That's yes. A telltale sign it's a deer and not a rabbit. Right. Rabbits are going to clip them at a pretty good 45 degree angle.
And every one of these.
Nice clean cut.
Right.
Another food source.
That's right. They have to eat. So they're going to take whatever they can get. And hopefully come spring, there'll still be enough of the bush left, which these will, that they'll just recover and do just fine. This church was rebuilt after a fire, and they planned out very carefully how they would place the building and also how they would make it more ecologically friendly by making these swales and planting native plants instead of using commercially grown plants, so that it became a preserve, really, for not only plants, but also the animals and birds that live on a prairie. So it's a great, great setting to show how a prairie probably did look in the past.
Well, they've been working very diligently and maintaining the prairie gardens. Would love to come back and do a video when they actually do a burn on part of the property.
Yes.
As well.
Because that's all part of it.
Yep.
We hope you enjoyed our short and nippy tour of the prairie at the end of winter. And if you did, please give us a thumbs up. You'd be supporting our Wisconsin Garden blog and also the Redeemer United Church of Christ and their efforts. We'd always love to hear your comments. And if you'd like to become part of our garden family, please subscribe.
I suppose now you want to go in and have some hot chocolate or something else?
Yes. Yes. Yes, I do.
Oh, what if I keep you out here for a little longer?
No, my lips will freeze.
Okay. Hey. I can actually get you to stop talking.
Connect with us on YouTube.